People, Fortnite China has done it again. So back in September, we showed you everything different in Fortnite China compared to the normal version. Remember when they banned Skulls, so they just turned like Mystique's backfling into a ball? It's gotten worse, people. Look what they did to Crackshot. Let's jump straight into it with number 10, the Taskmaster skin. So like I said, one of the weirdest things about Fortnite China is the fact that the government actually doesn't allow Skulls in video games, like, at all. Apparently, China has some really vague and strict laws that say you can't add things in games that will offend anyone, and while I understand it, it's kind of vague, so developers don't actually have an idea of what's considered offensive, so they don't take any risks. And because of this, most video games in China just don't have Skulls in them, because Skulls are considered offensive in China, apparently. So developers don't want to break the law and get their game banned just because they had some skeleton heads. And it turns out Epic Games is no stranger to this, as they've been removing Skulls from skins for years. That brings us to the leaked Taskmaster skin. This is one of the three outfits that will be coming out in the Marvel Royalty and Warriors pack, which could be coming to the item shop pretty much any day now. I mean, Taskmaster looks pretty cool, I won't lie, but this is what Taskmaster looks like in Fortnite China. Yeah, it's terrible. I mean, hey, some people might like this one, but it just doesn't have the feel as the original design. It's not all bad though, because something that China has an advantage over us is number 9, V-Buck Bounties. So in Fortnite China, you actually aren't allowed to buy V-Bucks with real life money because of the Chinese government's laws against microtransactions. And so because of this, they actually get a huge advantage. A majority of V-Bucks that people get in Fortnite China are from special events and challenges. You even get the Battle Pass entirely for free if you reach level 30. And just for Season 5, the brand new update, Fortnite China has added exclusive bounties to the game. These aren't like the bounties we have where you can take out an enemy player for gold bars. No, way better. Every 6 days, a brand new bounty challenge appears in-game for each Battle Pass outfit, and if you complete it, you get 400 V-Bucks for free. So not only do you get the Battle Pass for free, but you also get 400 V-Bucks every 6 days for no reason. Let me know if you guys would want something like this in our version of the game, but not all the changes in China are something to be jealous of. That brings us to number 8, what husks look like in China. So I mentioned earlier that China has some laws that ban Skulls, which also surprisingly applies to something in Fortnite that you wouldn't expect. Of course, Save the World is also available in China, not just Battle Royale, so there are actually some changes in that mode too. So this is a photo of what husks look like in the regular, unchanged version of Save the World. You probably recognize them. But they are actually different in China, especially their faces. Here's what they look like in the Chinese version, and as you can see, they look more like something from like Plants vs. Zombies than a skeleton zombie hybrid. I mean, it makes sense, it just shows what kind of lengths Epic is gonna do to obey the laws in the country, but something even more surprising is number 7, Fortnite China doesn't have arena mode. One of the biggest differences between the Western version and Chinese version of Fortnite is something as simple as a game mode, arena in fact. Fortnite China never had arena in the first place. While we were all asking for actual tournaments and a mode for people to compete in, China never got it at all and still has no Fortnite competitive to this day. And it's probably because China has some pretty strict laws which add a curfew to the amount of time people can actually play video games. If you didn't know, every game in China has some sort of time limit on it, and because of this, Fortnite just doesn't have arena. It makes a lot of sense though, a lot of tournament matches go on for way longer than regular games, and putting a time limit on a competitive match would kind of, well, ruin the point. So that's why Fortnite China just didn't even bother adding it at all. The time limit is really what separates China from the rest of the world, but it wasn't just arena that got removed because of the law. They also got rid of LTMs because they last way longer than usual matches, and once again, it would break that curfew. And it's pretty crazy to think that people in China have never experienced things like Air Royale, Floor is Lava, maybe even Team Rumble. I mean, sure they get free V-Bucks, but missing out on modes like this kinda isn't worth it. But now for another devastating blow to Fortnite, coming in at number 6, taking a look at what Crackshot looks like in China. So if you didn't know, in the regular version of Fortnite, the Crackshot skin has received a new variant, which is pretty much just the Skull Trooper design copy-pasted onto it. But the second I said Skull Trooper, you already know what Epic did to this thing in China. Here's what's weird though, the way Epic ended up removing the Skull design from this Crackshot variant is really funny. So, did they just not release the variant, maybe completely redesigned it? No, they just did, well, this. Like, come on, this is just funny. I get that it's annoying having to change designs for just a single country, but they really just clicked on this dude's mouth and pressed delete. And while removing Skulls is probably really annoying for Epic, something that is more annoying for us is number 5, Fortnite China doesn't have support or creator. I gotta say, one of the saddest differences between regular Fortnite and Fortnite China is probably this one. For some reason, the Chinese version of Fortnite never added the supporter creator system in the first place. And I gotta say, this has to be one of the worst things about Fortnite China. I mean, imagine not being able to punch in code T5G when buying stuff. But seriously though, there are a ton of great content creators in the country, and the supporter creator program has been really helpful to a ton of streamers and YouTubers. I mean, why not spread that love to Chinese creators or allow people from China to support who they watch? Now, really putting it into perspective, I think the reason they don't have this system is because you can't spend money on microtransactions or buy V-Bucks, so it'd be kinda hard to support creators if you're not allowed to actually spend money. But hey, maybe they'll find some other way to do this in the future. But moving on, there's a huge new addition to Fortnite China with number 4, China's Secret Lunar New Year event. So last year, Fortnite China received a Lunar New Year event, and it looks like it might return for this year too. It runs for a week during the Lunar New Year and includes a ton of exclusive skins for the event, including challenges for V-Bucks, special activities, and more. There are skins like the Smoke Dragon set, Jade Racer, Gan, Tigress, and Swift, which kinda looks like the Chinese New Year version of the Drift skin. I mean, it's pretty neat, I wish we get stuff like this in the regular version, but it makes sense that they're kind of exclusive to the whole Lunar New Year event. While LTMs aren't a regular Fortnite China, this event actually has a special exclusive LTM that is essentially hide and seek. They even give away a laptop and more prizes just for playing. It sounds pretty cool. But now it's time for the final weird things in China, starting off with other skins that have changed. Alright, sure, we've watched the Husk turn into actual zombies, Taskmaster get some ugly weird mask, and then Crackshot just getting, well, that happening. But there's way more skins I got changed to in Season 5, even the new Battle Pass skins. You know the top tier skin for this season, Menace? Well, he doesn't have any skulls on his helmet, instead Epic changed it to a weird helmet that looks like the Punisher's logo. As for the other skins, they updated Brutus's shadow version to just him with no sunglasses. He just doesn't have a skull mask anymore, which is really weird, and the same goes with Jules, who just has a black ski mask on. Then, all of Blackheart's stages with the skeleton underneath it just have a blank hood with cool effects inside. I mean, to be honest, I kinda prefer this to the original, honestly. And then finally, we have the Eternal Voyager, which is a completely different design compared to his original look, and I'm not sure if I like it or not, but do you? Let me know in the comments. Of course, we can't forget about Mystique's skull back bling, and I kid you not, they just made it a ball, like a literal ball, that's it, it's hilarious. And while these skins were changed, sometimes Epic just can't go through the effort to actually change some things, and instead just straight up remove them. It's time we hear about number 2, every banned skin in China. Alright, this one makes sense, but because of everything, well, about this guy, Epic Games never added the Ghost Rider skin into Fortnite China. It's one thing changing a skull design on an original character, but being a flaming skeleton is like Ghost Rider's entire thing, so he's banned in China. But even some of Fortnite's most famous characters have gone completely ignored in the Chinese version because they were just never added. For example, we all know about Skull Trooper? Well, gone. Skull Ranger? Deleted. The Peely Bone skin? Banned. In fact, even when you look back at the famous loading screen from the end event, Epic went through all the trouble to replace Skull Trooper with Raven just for the Chinese promotion. And while all this is just crazy, it brings us to the most insane difference of all. Let's get into number 1, everyone gets to win in Fortnite China. So there's quite a few changes in the Chinese version that makes Victory Royales completely different and easy for every player to get. Remember the curfew law that I mentioned earlier? That's pretty much the reason that Fortnite China is so different to the rest of the world, so let's talk about it. For starters, Fortnite China actually encourages you to leave the match if you have the most amount of kills in the game. So basically, if you're having a really good match, popping off, whatever, then Fortnite will simply tell you to quit the game and take your easy Victory Royale early. And instead of only having one person win the game, Fortnite China just lets everyone win if they're still alive by the time 20 minutes have passed. You don't even need to take out the remaining people, you just win the match for surviving 20 minutes. And that's not all, because of the time limits in China, you get huge restrictions on your game if you've been playing for longer than 3 hours. After a 3-hour session, Fortnite will give you a message pop-up that tells you to take a break immediately, and then just straight up disables XP and challenges, so playing the game becomes pointless. So, that 3-hour session limit combined with the 20-minute match limit, it's a lot to think about. I mean, would you be angry if the regular Fortnite version had this? Probably, but, you know, they also get free V-Bucks and exclusive events like the Lunar New Year. So, I guess everything has its pros and cons. But click on screen right now to check out this video. This has been Tommy, and you're watching Top 5 Gaming.